This is the Waken Setup Guide. In this video, I'm going to lay out all the things you need to know to help you set up your custom red and amber blue light blocking screen filters. Included with every screen are adhesive hooks. You will receive 4 for smaller screens like computer monitors, and for TVs, you will receive 8 adhesive hooks. Also included are 2 cords with a wheel cord lock mechanism and with a suspender clip at the end. We included these cords for the alternative method of attaching your screen to your TV in case you don't want to stick adhesive hooks to the back of your TV, or in some rare instances, some TVs or computer monitors won't have a surface that will work with the adhesive hooks. I will lay out both methods used to attach your screens in this video. Every screen is designed for quick and easy installation to give you as much flexibility in your everyday use. The red screen is designed to slip over your amber screen. Most people will use the amber screen during the day or at times when they need to see color. At night, when we want to protect our circadian rhythm, we install the red filter for maximum protection from blue and green spectrums of light. All right, let's get started. By now, you probably unrolled your screen. During shipping, the plastic was exposed to a wide range of temperatures, which may have caused wrinkles. The best way to unwrinkle and flatten your screen is with heat. My favorite method is simply laying the screen out in warm sun for a few minutes. If it's too cold outside, the other method I like is to stick your screens in a hot bath or shower for a few minutes. Then lay your screens on a flat and dry surface and towel them off. The heat given off from your TV screen over time will also get rid of any wrinkles you might have. Now we are ready to attach the screen filters to your TV. Note in this image what side is the top of your filter and which side is the bottom. There will be a rectangle cut out of the bottom of the filter. Next, we want to get the screen positioned nice and center on your TV. I recommend getting some tape to help you position the screen. All you need is a small piece of tape placed at the center of your filter. Now position the screen so that it's nice and center, so there is an even amount of plastic filter that spills out over the left and to the right, to the top and to the bottom. Note that most filters will have excess materials on both ends that you will want to cut off in a later step after getting the screen fully installed. Now that your screen is nice and center on your TV, we can move on to placing the adhesive hooks to the back of your TV. Figure out the places where you might stick the adhesive hooks. Test the elastic band tension to determine where to place the hooks. You don't want the tension to be too loose, but it doesn't need to be too tight. Once you've determined where you're going to place your adhesive hooks, you next need to clean the back of your TV in those spots with the alcohol wipe included with your screen. Each adhesive hook should hold up to 13 pounds of force, but to ensure they stick properly, make sure to clean any dust or oils from the back of your TV. Some TVs might have a rough surface, not conducive for the adhesive hooks, or there might not be any flat areas to attach the needed adhesive hooks, and in this case, you will need to use the alternative method in attaching your screens. Now that the surface is clean and we know where the hooks need to be placed, we can go ahead and stick all the adhesive backed hooks to the back of your TV. Make sure each hook is going the correct direction before adhering it. For the alternative method of attaching your filter to your TV, I've included 2 cords with locking clamps and suspender clips. You will want to tie the end without the clip to the top corner elastic bands. Now, clamp the suspender clips to the bottom corner elastic bands. You will pull the cord at the wheel cord locking clamp to tighten the cord. The cord can easily be loosened and the suspender clips unclamped for easy and quick removal. The only step left now is to remove any excess material spilling out left and right of your screen. Get a marker and mark at the 4 corners where you would like to cut the material. I recommend leaving an 1/8 to a 1/4 of an inch spilling over on both ends to give you some leeway when putting on your filters. A little excess material will also help reduce any light from escaping out the sides. Now remove the screen and lay them flat on the ground. You will need some sort of straight edge. In this video, I used a piece of wood to draw a straight cutting line from top to bottom. Then carefully cut the excess material with scissors or a razor blade. You are now set to go and should now be able to quickly attach or remove your screen filters. If you only ordered one of our colors, you can order the amber or red at any time and you should receive the same size screen that will work with your current setup.